Hi, my name is Tyson Brown. I'm with the Academic Support Group here within ICT at the U of S, and I'm here today to give you a really, really quick overview of student response systems. So today we're going to look at some of the basics of what an SRS system, aka clickers, is, why you'd use them, how you could use them, and a really brief look at what's out there. So you're all familiar with the standard process of an instructor asking a question and a student providing a response. But what if you get a whole lot of responses? How constructive is that? What if there was a way to easily and quickly capture and organize student responses? And that is what a student response system is. It consists of three basic components: a software package that allows you to display the question for your students, a response device that enables your students to respond to the question, and a receiver of some kind that captures the responses and passes them to the software package. The software package then stores the responses and allows you to organize them, analyze them, and report on them. So now, why would you use this? Number one reason, engagement, student engagement and learning. We can talk about constructivist learning theory, which states that learning is not a passive exercise. There's been extensive research all the way back to Dewey in 1916 that shows that students learn more if they are engaged in constructing the knowledge in their brains. Assessing prior knowledge, helping you quickly determine your audience's prior knowledge. How many of you walk into a classroom before a lesson and ask students about what they already know? Put up your hands if you know X. Student response systems can really assist you with that by A, letting you speed up that process, B, helping you keep track of what your students knew to begin with, and C, letting you customize what you're going to offer in your upcoming training based on a quick glance at the student's existing knowledge base. Formative assessment. It's one of those things that instructors find really hard to do in the traditional classroom. Where do you find the time to hit students with more requests for feedback about what they're learning? And if you get them to do it in writing, then they expect you to mark it. What if you had some way to sneakily perform formative assessment without them even knowing you were doing it? And as a bonus, it would do all the marking for you. The best part about using SRS for formative assessment is that it helps you, at point of teaching, assess both the effectiveness of the student's learning and the effectiveness of your own teaching. What if you asked a question about a concept you just taught and nobody got the answer right? That should tell you that maybe you need to look back at your question. Sensitive issues, abortion, religion, sexual abuse, morality, cheating on exams. These are just some topics that are uncomfortable for many people to discuss in the classroom openly with everybody watching. SRS systems that provide anonymity and immediacy of response can really help you as a teacher work through these topics with your students in real time without anyone feeling threatened or outed. It's also really helpful for ethics approval for any studies you'd be doing dealing with sensitive issues like this. So let's look at what's out there. We've got two basic kinds of SRS systems: hardware SRS solutions, and these are things like Turning Technologies or iClicker, and they consist of a hardware clicker, a hardware receiver, or a smartphone app with internet access, and then usually a PC or Mac-based software package to install on your computer. They usually integrate with PowerPoint, or they can be standalone or floating to allow polling with other apps. And so here's just a very, very brief graphic of how it works. Software displays the slide so that the students can use their clicker to respond to the receiver. The receiver then sends those responses to the software, which stores them for your future use. The hybrid portion involves connecting the software to the internet so that you can connect your smartphone to the internet to receive the question and respond to it. You can also use browsers or any internet-connected device usually. So some of the pros of the hardware hybrid solution: works very well to create seamless integration with PowerPoint or other desktop applications you might be using in your teaching. Your data never leaves the room or your control unless you use the hybrid portion of the system. Your responses are not dependent on the reliability or the availability of the internet. And you can deploy the hardware spontaneously. So you can walk into a room with a bunch of people, hand out a bunch of clickers, and say, "We're going to use clickers today so that I can evaluate your responses." The clicker hardware is very reliable and relatively cheap. In my 5 years of using the Turning Technologies clickers, I have seen three clickers fail. What's out there? Hardware hybrid solutions for cons. It is harder to integrate with BYOD. If your students want to use their own devices, that's a little more difficult. It can be expensive to integrate with BYOD. There is some infrastructure that has to be put into place with that. And your data management and analysis can be overwhelming because you are responsible for it. You're responsible for making sure you capture your results and that you get them into the analysis system properly. And it is somewhat less flexible in terms of your question types. Software SRSs. These are things like Top Hat, formerly Top Hat Monocle, and Learning Catalytics. And these are no hardware components at all. They're all internet-based. So you use your browser or your smartphone. Some of them actually even have the ability to text responses in. So you as an instructor prepare your questions online. You display the questions for the students online via the browser. They respond via their internet connection, and your responses are kept in the cloud-based SRS system. So the pros of this, less infrastructure required, although there's a small caveat to that. The browser-based HTML-based stuff allows for some fairly nifty question types, things like image map question types. And the hosted solution requires less data management on your part. The data is stored without you having to worry about it, and you're able to access it that way. Caters to BYOD, really. Because you're going to be working with people who have their own devices with them. Now, our caveat here in terms of less infrastructure is that it is dependent on internet availability. So let's look at the cons here. And the number one big con for me is that your question data is stored off-site. Question data and results. If you're dealing with sensitive issues, you may not want that. Heavily dependent on internet access. Without internet access, you're dead in the water. You can't write questions, you can't pull questions, you can't deal with your results. There is some complexity to polling while working with other apps. If you're using PowerPoint and you want to use one of the software SRSs, you actually have to flip over to the browser to use it to do your polling. It's difficult to do spontaneous and ad hoc polling because you have to warn your audience to bring a device to be connected to the internet, and you have to get them connected to the service that they're using or that you're using. So just a few quick references, some information about the pedagogical effectiveness of SRSs from Eric's system there, and some case studies, and a little bit of video of a keynote that we arranged in 2013 summer of clickers. So some contact information. If you do want to take a look at a hardware clicker solution, please do give me a call. Again, my name is Tyson Brown, and I'm the clicker service manager here for the U.S. within ICT. Thanks very much, and have a nice day.